And I'd like to welcome each of you, family and friends of Lorette Barrette, today here to St. Simon and St. Jude Church for this Mass to remember her and to give homage as well. My name is Father Rob Reno. I'm the Associate Pastor here at St. Simon and St. Jude and for the Windsor Lake St. Clair Catholic Family of Parishes. And with me today is Father Eugene Roy, who's a good friend of Lorette. I'd also like to welcome those joining us online, I believe, from California. So we're reaching far and wide today as we remember Lorette. Bienvenue ici à Saint-Simon Saint-Jude. Je m'appelle le Père Robert Renaud et avec moi, c'est le Père Eugène Roy. Et bienvenue aussi à tous ceux et celles qui se joignent à nous en ligne. Prions le Seigneur. Dieu Père Tout-Puissant, notre foi proclame que ton Fils est mort et ressuscité par ce mystère. Accorde dans ta bonté ta servante Lorette, qui s'est endormie dans le Christ, la joie de ressusciter par ce même Jésus-Christ. Lui qui vit et règne avec toi dans l'unité du Saint-Esprit, Dieu pour les siècles des siècles.
Amen. Please be seated. We invite Hayden to come forward to proclaim the first reading.
A reading from the book of Job. Job answered, "Oh, that my words were written down. Oh, that they were inscribed in a book. Oh, that with an iron pen and with lead, they were engraved on a rock forever. For I know that my Redeemer lives, and that at the last he will stand upon the earth after my skin has been thus destroyed. Then in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see on my side, and my eyes shall behold, and not another, the word of the Lord. Thanks to be God."
Please join us in singing the psalm response, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want." Thank you. We invite Candace to come forward to proclaim the second reading.
Lecture de la deuxième lettre de Saint Paul à Timothée. Bien-aimé, moi, en effet, je suis déjà offert en sacrifice. Le moment de mon départ est venu. J'ai mené le bon combat. J'ai achevé ma course. J'ai gardé la foi. Je n'ai plus qu'à recevoir la couronne de la justice. Le Seigneur, le juste juge, me la remettra en ce jour-là, et non seulement à moi, mais aussi à tous ceux qui auront désiré avec amour sa manifestation glorieuse. Parole du Seigneur.
Bon, grâce à Dieu.
Please stand.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
And Jesus answered them, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit, a rich harvest. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Now my soul is troubled, and what should I say? Father, save me from this hour? No. It is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven, "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
It is good once again to be in your company, in your presence. And I'm truly honored, and I thank the pastor, Father Patrick Beneteau, and Father Robert Renaud for allowing me to be accompanying them and accompanying the family of Lorette. And as I was driving down the 401 this morning from London, clear roads, I hear it was a bit unweathery last night, but I couldn't help but think, let's start with rolling back the clocks 30 years ago. I can't believe, I said to myself, I was here as a pastor 35 years ago. I was 35. I'll let you figure out the math from that point. But a young pastor had just returned from Latin America. I'd spent 5 years in the missionary lands, and I followed, of course, on the footsteps of another Father Roy, Father Paul Roy, whom I knew very well and who had come to visit frequently in those days. But nonetheless, knock off 30 years, and we can ask ourselves, about 50% of the young ones wouldn't have been around. In fact, the parents of these young ones were themselves the young ones. And it is wonderful to see how the seed of Lorette was indeed died to herself in order that a rich harvest indeed could be known, could be experienced. And we celebrate the gift of her wisdom. When we think of 92 years of age, there's a lot of wisdom. And wisdom is that blend of experience and knowledge, and how we put it to the service of one another. And some of that wisdom, la sagesse, on parle souvent des enfants qui sont sages, en voulant dire qu'ils écoutent, ils sont attentifs, ils sont alertes, ils sont ouverts à vouloir apprendre et assimiler et obéir, oui, il faut avoir de l'obéissance, mais à la fois toujours avec, comment est-ce qu'on dirait, le point d'être bien préparé lorsqu'on continue à grandir. Et on se construit d'une étape à l'autre et notre connaissance s'élargit, s'épanouit. And as we appropriate this experience of learning, yes, a lot of it sometimes is repetition and memory, but then the light bulbs start coming on when we make sense out of why I'm learning what I'm learning. And usually the best teachers are our parents. Yes, we have a school system that accompany the parents in their responsibility in forming not only the mind, but and just information up here, but of the heart, and how to listen with kindness, with respect, and with appreciation, gratitude. And when we look to our grandmother, our great-grandmother, and great-great-grandmother, there is a lot of meaning that gets handed down from one generation to another. And what is it that is important to be handed down from one generation to another is the experience of meeting and encountering the Word of God made flesh, the stories of faith as revealed to us through Jesus, the Son of God, the Son of Mary, the one who shared completely in our human experience from birth to death, but at the same time is the Word of God, the divine word energy that sustains us in this very moment. Thank God, God doesn't take a nap, but all disappear. But no, the reality of encountering Jesus is mediated, it's expressed through lived experiences of daily living. And so when I arrived 30 years ago, what were some of the characteristics that I encountered in this wonderful community of Saint Simon and Jude? Évidemment, l'accueil, a warm welcome, d'être accueilli, to be warmly welcomed. And it was wonderful to, in a sense, meet some of my own parents' childhood, young adolescent, young adult relationships. It's always great to visit. And I remember Lorette, your grandmother, your mother saying, j'ai changé tes couches quand t'étais petit garçon. Well, lucky for you, Lorette. Terrible task to accomplish, but she changed my diapers as an infant, is what I just finished saying. And I said, lucky for you, Lorette, you know. But the thing is, these were acquaintances of the family. And all of this care and nurturing, you know, is there, and we catch a glimpse of what it was like for when our parents were themselves children and young people. And that's why we have stories and share these stories, even if it is about changing diapers or being nourished. But these are the stories of everyday life. And growing up, we experience complete dependence upon our parents. Then we hit that point of adolescence where we want to experience our independence. And that's wonderful. It's a trial and error for many of us. But yet, there comes a point as adults and maturing adults that we recognize that we have the interdependence. And that is very important, to go from total dependence to total independence, but then as a result of marrying or integrating life's experience and knowledge, we begin to encounter and taste la sagesse, to taste wisdom. And when we are at crossroads, guess what? Grandmama, what did you do when you fell in love with Grandpapa Luc? How was it for you? Those are very important questions. Where did you learn? Who were your mom and dad? What were they about? And all of these stories, sometimes the reason why we have photo albums, we don't use photo albums anymore, we just go in a digitalized way of seeing things instantly. You know, you get a picture and instantly it's sent across the world through the World Wide Web network. Rapid information sharing that once ago, 30 years ago, we had to wait, take a picture, finish the film, send it to a processing company, Quebec, and then we get the photo. Well, we know that's ancient history for our young people today. What do you mean you had to wait all that time? Or even writing letters, you know, to the loved ones. They didn't have the internet. They didn't have Instagram and Facebook and all of the new platforms that are surfacing today. They had to wait 15 days. Well, God bless you. If your husband says, how are you doing, honey? And you wait 2 weeks to respond to it, relationships are going to be in trouble, eh? Huh? Relationships, even young people, you expect it immediately. And then we can lose sight. Another aspect of sagesse, of wisdom, comes patience, la patience. And patience is closely related to wisdom, because you can add all of the fertilizer you want to a plant, to a tree, to a crop. It's not going to go any faster than what it was intended to grow. Healthy, yes. Hopefully, you know, bug-free, yes. Disease-free, yes. But you can look at it from many angles, and it's only going to grow so fast at its own pace. And so one thing about the farming community to teach the rest of this urbanized society is have patience. And patience is very much tied into the time of God. And at 92 years of age, did Lorette have patience? She waited, and suddenly she was called. She got on the bus to heaven, and now we will accompany her with our prayers, with our memories, with her legacy, and continue to share these stories of faith. And what is the fundamental story that needs to be threaded throughout history is, how has Lorette loved you, and how have you expressed Lorette's love to one another? That is the disciple, to be vessels, the contenu, the vessels of the love of Jesus. And that's the fundamental command in any of our encounters with Jesus. It is to love one another as he has loved us. And that love of Jesus was poured out for us on the cross. And why the cross for us is so fundamental? Because it speaks of freeing ourselves from the power of sin, but at the same time, it is the expectation that God loves to encounter and delights to be in our company. But we are offering up the challenges of life in faith and embracing it in love, because that's what God said to the world that day when Jesus died. And Jesus died as that seed, and he says, but when I die, that seed will yield a rich harvest, and the harvest that Lorette shares for us, because I have glorified your name, Lord Jesus, and I will glorify it again. And what does he mean? In each and every one of us, le nom de Jésus sera glorifié encore, et à travers toutes les générations, nous célébrerons cet amour que Jésus cherche en nous et nous invite de le partager avec les autres. And so may the soul of Lorette, our sister, rest in peace, and may the legacy of her love be spread from generation to generation. Amen.
We invite forward Brett and Curtis to lead us in the prayers of the faithful. Please stand.
My brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in him, we join our prayers to his.
For Meme, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For our sister who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our sister Meme, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the depth of his friend Lazarus. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. Our offertory gifts of bread and wine will be brought forward to the altar by Loretta's great-grandchildren, and our offertory hymn will be on the screen. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, Lorette, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up
to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is
right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Please kneel.
Toi qui es vraiment saint, toi qui es la source de toute sainteté, Seigneur, nous te prions. Sanctifie ces offrandes en répandant sur elles ton esprit, qu'elles deviennent pour nous le corps et le sang de Jésus, le Christ, notre Seigneur. Moment d'être livré et d'entrer librement dans sa passion, il prit le pain, il le rendit grâce, il le rompit et le donna à ses disciples en disant, « Venez et mangez-en tous, ceci est mon corps livré pour vous. » De même, après le repas, il prit le coupe. De nouveau, il rendit grâce et le donna à ses disciples en disant, « Prenez et buvez-en tous, car ceci est la coupe de mon sang, le sang de l'Alliance nouvelle et éternelle, qui sera versé pour vous et pour la multitude en rémission des péchés. Vous ferez cela en mémoire de moi. » Il est grand le mystère de la foi. Faisant ainsi mémoire de la mort et de la résurrection de ton Fils, nous t'offrons, Seigneur, le pain de la vie et la coupe du salut, et nous te rendons grâce, car tu nous as estimés dignes de nous tenir devant toi pour te servir. Humblement, nous te demandons qu'en à part au corps et au sang du Christ, nous soyons rassemblés par l'Esprit Saint en un seul corps.
Souviens-toi, Seigneur, de ton Église, répandue à travers le monde, fais-la grandir dans ta charité en union avec notre pape François, notre évêque Ronald, Joseph, son évêque auxiliaire, et tous les évêques, les prêtres et les diacres. Souviens-toi aussi de celle qui a quitté ce monde et que tu appelles auprès de toi. Puisque Lorette a été unie à la mort de ton Fils, accorde-lui de participer à sa résurrection.
Souviens-toi aussi de nos frères et sœurs qui se sont endormis dans l'espérance de la résurrection. Souviens-toi dans ta miséricorde de tous les défunts. Accueille-les dans la lumière de ton visage. Et sur nous tous, enfin, nous implorons ta bonté. Permets qu'avec la Vierge Marie, la bienheureuse Mère de Dieu, avec Saint Joseph, son époux, les apôtres Simon et Jude, et tous les saints qui ont fait ta joie au long des âges, nous ayons part à la vie éternelle et que nous chantions ta louange et ta gloire par ton Fils Jésus le Christ.
Par lui, avec lui et en lui, à toi, Dieu le Père Tout-Puissant, dans l'unité du Saint-Esprit, de l'honneur et toute gloire pour les siècles des siècles.
Amen.
Please stand.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Say the word, so shall be.
We now prepare to come forward to receive Holy Communion. If you are not of the Catholic faith, or if you are not receiving communion today, when coming forward, please cross your arms over your chest, and you will receive a prayer of blessing. Or if you prefer, you may also remain in your pews. Please remain standing until the last person has received Eucharist. Our communion hymn will be on the screen. please stand?
Seigneur. Seigneur Dieu, ton Fils nous a laissé dans le sacrement de son corps les vivres dont nous avons besoin pour la route qui mène à toi. Dans ta bonté, accorde à notre sœur de parvenir par ce sacrement jusqu'à la table où le Christ la convie dans l'éternité. Lui qui vit et règne pour les siècles des siècles.
Amen.
I just want to offer a couple words of thanks, of course, to our singers and our organists, to Linda and Lorna for the beautiful music today, for Lorette, for all the family here, just providing that support to one another and to the immediate family here. I'd like to thank Father Eugene for joining us today. He's kind of my boss, so I was a little nervous, especially with the French, but... Also to Kathy, our commentator, to Dan, Yvonne, and to Jen as well for serving us today, and to our funeral home directors. I believe we'll have an announcement just after about a lunch there at Mr. Biggs. You can remind them again. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In baptism, Lorette shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. May she be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. As a sign of respect for our sister Lorette, we let this incense rise to God, who has called her to share in his glory. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Lorette, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Lorette in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. Dear friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God's peace for you. And in peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
I have one announcement. The family would like to invite everyone for a luncheon at Mr. Biggs following the committal prayers at St. Simon and St. Jude Cemetery. Let us go forward, strengthened by our hope in the resurrection of Jesus Christ, as we continue to pray for the Barrette family. Our recessional hymn, How Great Thou Art, will be on the screen.